is how the crypto market's feeling right now. You know, it is a total bloodbath out there. We had core inflation numbers for the U.S. today. Came out better than expected. However, I'm pretty sure everybody thinks it's a lie because Wall Street is responding. Also, it turns out Russia's out there getting wild with their wanting to come after the West thing. That's making it to where all tech stocks are dumping hard. You can see literally every single thing is in the red. But for some reason, not that much is going into gold either. What are they doing? Are they holding dollars? Is the DXY that good? I don't know. But what we're going to do, we're going to do a little TA on Bitcoin. We're going to do TA on what I believe is the most undervalued token in the entire crypto space, Fantom. And let's see what we have to look forward to this weekend. Because let me tell you, oversold markets make for great gains on the weekend. Let me tell you that. Anyways, let's jump right into it. If you have not hit the subscribe button, please do. Hit the bell for notifications because all of these are time sensitive. Follow me on Twitch if you want live streams going over the charts, and you can get all of your requests there. Follow me on Twitter. Get into the Discord. Get notified every single time I upload a video and go live. Other than that, let's dive right in, on into these markets. So first off, we're going to look at Fantom, FTM. We're going to go to the daily time frame right now. So in the daily, we can see we have not seen levels this low since all the way back here. First time we saw them was May 7th, 2021, last year, literally a year ago. This time, May 6th, a year ago, we've not seen it. Wow, amazing. So then after that, we got to see it again September 1st. Last year. What do we have to look forward to on this price now? Because, you know, we hit it once. By the next time we hit it, we just took off and never looked back. Guess we're looking back now. Anyways, look on the daily. I don't think I need to tell you we're oversold. But we are. We're oversold. We have this massive falling channel we've been in. And also, if I redraw these lines, this falling channel is going to show something very, very interesting. Very, very interesting. You know, I'm just going to get rid of all of these lines so you can see exactly what I'm about to do. So, parallel channel here. You're gonna be shocked. You're going to be amazed. You're going to be like, oh my gosh, is he Houdini? No. I just look at charts too often. We just fell below the heart line. We just fell below it. All right? Now, we're solely focused on what is going to be our support. At these levels, support, we just fell under one level of support. We have a little pocket here of support. So we're in the pocket. If we lose this level, we have another lower level. And that lower level is right here from this previous peak all the way back here, August 23rd-ish, on that day. On that day. Almost like any given Sunday. But we also can argue there is one more tiny, minute little support, and that is this scuffy little support that we're sitting on right this moment. So, those are our support levels. This is where we're sitting. We just dropped below the heart line, fell through it with a vengeance. We are what looks to be finding support at this level at the 81 cent range. If we do fall below, we're looking to get caught right here on 78 cents. We're looking to get caught right there. If this falls out very fast, we're falling down to 61 cents again on FTM. What I am thinking will happen on the shorter time frame, we might trade a little sideways here, but we got to get back up to this 20 EMA. We got to get back up to that 20 EMA, or it's got to come to us. Either way, I believe we are going to get a short rally, 32% possible. I mean, if you want to lowball it a little bit, you could look at a possible rally of 23%. Now, noted, your stop loss is actually going to be the bottom of this daily candle, sitting here at 79.65. You don't want to see anything lower than that. As soon as you see something lower than that, you're going to be trying to test the 77, 78 range. And if it falls out, oof, it's looking bad. Looking real bad. Anyways, let's go down to the 4-hour time frame. to see how overbought we are, or oversold we are. We just started a new 4-hour candle. You can see we did close right above our support level. This is a very good sign. Very good sign. We could see a tiny little relief rally due to the so much dumping. Oh my goodness. You haven't seen dumps like this since Taco Night. Anyways, we are probably more than likely going to see a short-term up little relief rally because we are so oversold. Let's go ahead and drop down to the 1-hour time frame. 1-hour time frame is showing we're completely oversold also. So we barely even need interest at this moment. We just need people to be there to be like, oops, I hit buy. And this price is going to start going up. But I do highly believe FTM is severely oversold right now. I do not believe these low prices are going to last very long. But this is solely dependent on Bitcoin. Solely dependent on Bitcoin. So if the macro goes down, we're toast. If the macro goes up, we could very, very quickly see FTM come straight back to the top of this channel. 38% rise to the upside up to $1.14. So this is a big time gamble, guys, because it is super bearish. What I personally think would be a good idea for some of you, you know, DCA. These are the levels. DCA. Lots of value in these levels. Severely oversold. Heck, we can even see on the weekly how oversold are we. We are crazy oversold. On the weekly, our 20 EMA is sitting up here at $1.50. That's how oversold we are. That just think of that. Last time we fell this far below our 20 EMA, we had 3 weeks of rallying out of FTM. So keep that in mind. We could start seeing a lot of bullishness out of FTM. When you're oversold on the weekly, that does not go unnoticed. It does not go unnoticed. So understand where you're at. Just understand. Anyways, let's go ahead and check out Bitcoin, because Bitcoin's been going through it. It's been going through it. So on the weekly, you can see Bitcoin is sitting in oversold territory. However, we are utilizing the 100 EMA as support on the weekly, which is very good. As the longer we hold it, the better. Now, I've been pretty darn bullish on Bitcoin lately, but you know, with traders being so unrealistic on what they want, I don't know, guys. I don't know. We might see that random final dip. I keep saying this final dip. I believe there will be one final sell-off to scare off anybody who's not scared enough. Right now, the fear level's pretty high. It's pretty high. A lot of people are like, oh no, we're going to see way lower lows, way lower lows. Understand what we've been doing. Here's the daily time frame. We've been putting in this small little, I call it a bull flag, because this is accumulation downward, and not to mention, it is in an uptrend. In an uptrend. Accumulation down, in an uptrend. We fell to the bottom of the channel. We came up. We're back testing this former resistance as support. We are now testing it as support once again. If we can hold this on the daily, I would expect we start to see higher prices, even though it is a bearish candle. Now, also, don't get me wrong, we do have a little bit of room to fall. I'm not going to lie, because if you look at the relative strength index, we're sitting pretty darn close to the middle, so we do have room to fall. We could fall to the bottom of this channel, but if we do manage to fall out of this channel, you're looking to come, first off, to this support line down here, our little supply line, and we could see a $37,000 Bitcoin. If we break out of that, we also have another support sitting right down here at this larger channel, $35,300. So that would actually make it to where all those people who are doom and gloom saying, we're going to see a $36,000 Bitcoin, this would make all of their dreams come true. The amount of buying pressure that could possibly be down here, absolutely massive. Absolutely massive. So I do believe wherever we're sitting, it is very close to the bottom. The daily time frame is trying to move up. However, that's a little bearish in itself. Price has been going down. RSI, stochastic RSI started going up. A little bearish. But keep in mind, it's the end of the month. It is the final Friday of the month. Futures contracts are ending today. This is usually what happens when there's this much volatility. The whales are out there. They're selling off. Remember, final Friday And tomorrow's the final day of the month. Watch out. We might see a tremendous rally starting Monday. We might. I'm not saying we will. Just saying we might. With markets being this oversold, futures contracts ending, new month starting, we might see a big shift in the market, big shift in sentiment, big shift in everything. This could be our little shakeout period before we start seeing higher prices, so keep that in mind. For all of you day traders out there, let's go to a lower time frame for Bitcoin. Bitcoin does look like it is trying to put in a little bit of bullishness. We did regard this level at 38,100, something like that. Whatever this line is, that is what we utilized as support. We will see if it holds for the day, but it does look like you are about to start converging bullish, which is very good to see. You can see we do have bullish divergence already because Wall Street only has so much Bitcoin to sell. So I think that's why the altcoins are hurting so hard today, because they had some of those left on the balance sheet. They're getting rid of them. Just be careful there. Be careful. Let's go down to the 1 hour. 1 hour showing the same thing. We are starting to show a little less negative momentum on the MACD. This is a technical bullish divergence, double bullish divergence on the 1 hour. So this could just be a back test of former resistance. Now it's being flipped as support. Keep that in mind with your trades. Go down to the 15-minute. Even the 15-minute wants to move up. So every indicator is saying Bitcoin wants to move up, which then will help the rest of the market move up. Hopefully TA is not disrespected. Hopefully your stop losses are tight. Keep those stop losses tight. Minimize your risk by stopping the bleeding. Okay? Put a little tourniquet on your trades. Anyways, I hope this helps you out. Hopefully you guys are doing well. And yeah, definitely hit subscribe. Hit the like. Hit the bell. I already told you where we will more than likely find support if we do fall. So keep all of this in mind. Not financial advice. But hey, do your own research. Take it easy. I'm out of here. Deuces, y'all. Deuces.